Mga kaibigan, mayaman ang Mindanao. In fact, if only you will have the time to move around Mindanao, makikita mo yung potential ng isla na ito. For example, ito ang tanyag na Maria Cristina Falls. Ito po ay makikita sa ilog na ang tawag nila ay Agus River. Galing po ng Lake Lanao yung tubig at dumadaloy. Noong 1953, ito pong Agus River ay pinagawan ng hydropower dam. Simula noon, 7 dams na po ang ipinatayo along Agus River. Ang total power generation ng Agus River Hydropower Complex, 727 megawatts. That is one-third of the total power requirement of Mindanao. Tingnan po natin ang Maria Cristina Falls at i-discover natin ang beauty and bounty of Mindanao.
Kailan ginawa yung Agus 6?
It was commissioned by the former President Elpidio Quirino, sir.
Uh-huh.
And the first unit, if I'm not mistaken, operated, commercially operated in 1960s. That would be Unit 1 and 2. Uh-huh. And Unit 3, 4, 5 followed during the 1970s.
Okay. So, bali 7 na ito ngayon?
5 lang, sir.
5?
5 dito sa Agus 6, 2 sa Agus 7, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, anong total power generation natin?
Just for Agus 6 and 7 only, sir, we have around 250 megawatts of installed capacity, sir.
Pero simulan doon sa taas?
Okay.
Dito.
From Agus 1 to Agus 7, sir, we would be having a total of 727 megawatts of power, sir.
Ang laking contribution niyan sa Mindanao.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Was there a time na nagka-problema kayo dahil mababa yung tubig o whatever?
It was only, I think, around 1970s. I'm not very sure kasi hindi pa ako pinanganak noon, sir. Yung drought sa Mindanao, sir, if you can remember. Siguro, sir, bata-bata ka pa rin noon, sir, no?
Wala pa gihapong kwento.
Yes, sir. So I think that would be the only time that we could consider that there was a critical level in terms of the water supply.
Okay.
But often, on regular days, basta okay lang, walang problema sa mga basura or any other things, we are operating at very good capacity. But as of the moment, sir, as we have established that early on in 1960s, nag-operate na yung units natin. So that would make our units as old as 40 years old. And we know that the feasible economic life of any generating units would only run about 25 years. So I think our units are already long overdue.
Oh yes, okay, so that was the year na na-commission yung unang
yes, sir.
Hydropower yes, generation
sir.
Facility.
Yes, sir. But recently, sir, we had a project regarding Unit 1-2 because it was the oldest unit here in the whole Agus complex. It was, we cannot say replaced, but we can say uprated. No civil structure was altered whatsoever, but the internal mechanisms of the entire generating unit was successfully rehabilitated. But the project was not handled by NPC, but by PISAM. So it was rehabilitated, and right now we are running with Unit 1 and Unit number 2.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So far, lately, wala na kayong problema?
So far, sir, minor difficulties here and there. Normal man talaga yan, sir. Basta tayo, when we are running mechanical machines. So, but anything major, I think there are no notable major problems that we are encountering so far.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Mga kaibigan, nakita nyo ang isang yaman ng Mindanao. Maria Cristina Falls. Agus Hydro Power Complex. Total power generation, 727 megawatts. That's a lot of power. And this is actually one of the sources of power of Mindanao. Kulang pa ito sapagkat ang requirement ng Mindanao is 2,000 megawatts. But with this, sigurado tayong aasenso ang Mindanao. At pagdating ng panahon, lahat ng mga ito, ng mga proyektong ito, ay makakatulong sa pag-unlad ng Mindanao at pagkamit ng kapayapaan. Ganyan po kayaman ng Mindanao. Ito po ang beauty and bounty of Mindanao. Sa ngalan ng Mindanao Development Authority, ako po si Secretary Manny Piñol, nagsasabing, let us continue to discover the beauty and bounty of Mindanao.